Do you need to share the same files or folder with a variety of different clients? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to do exactly that right here in Google Drive. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And I'm going to show you exactly how I use Google Drive for my own business, how I can just share one single link with a variety of clients and make sure that they're always getting the most recent or most up-to-date files. But first, I'd like to thank today's sponsor, Ice Cream PDF Editor. If you're looking for an easy way to edit your PDF documents, you should try Ice Cream PDF Editor. It's 100% free, and it will allow you to edit your text, edit your objects, and perhaps one of my favorite features is rearranging and managing multiple PDF pages. So if you'd like to try Ice Cream PDF Editor for yourself, be sure to click the link in the description below. So let me show you exactly how I use Google Drive to share certain files and folders with my clients. First, let me give you my use case. I'm a speaker. At least a big portion of my business is speaking at conferences, giving keynotes, delivering workshops. And so after I engage with an event planner or someone who's hired me, I want to share particular documents with them. And so if we go back to Google Drive, I've got this folder called Folder for Client Resources. And when I click on that, I've got a few things that I share with everyone who hires me. I've got things like my headshot, a few pictures here that they might want to include in their marketing. I've got my bio, which will usually be included in a printout or a handout, or also on their website, and maybe a few different things that I include in the workshops themselves, some exercises that they may need to have access to so they can print them off in advance. Now, this collection of information I need to share with a wide variety of people, but it's not exactly private. I really don't care if you have access to this or if someone else stumbles upon it. There's nothing secure here, there's nothing private here, but I don't like including this information on my website because I'd rather not have someone just stumble upon that site and say, what is this? And what is this purpose? I also don't want to manage just an extra web page on my website. So instead, I've created this folder here within Google Drive. Now, if we go up here to the folder name, we can right-click and select Share. Now, you might be familiar with this pop-up that comes here, and probably you're used to entering in a name or an email address of the people that you want to share with. And of course, I could do this as well, right? I could just keep a long list, just keep adding people who need access to these files. But that's going to be very tedious, right? I'm going to have to come in here each and every time, find the email address, and in many cases, I'm dealing with just one individual and they want to be able to share this with other members of their team. And so then they need to ask for additional access and that type of thing. So in this case, instead of entering any email addresses, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click up here and say, get the shareable link. And what that's going to do is that anyone with the link, this is the default option that comes up, anyone with the link can view. So it's generated a unique link here. All I have to do is copy that link. I can copy that link. I can hit done down below. Now, again, you want to make sure that it says only can view. We're not giving people access to edit. The default choice is view. So let's make sure that we continue with that option there. But I've got my link now. I've copied it already. I'm going to say done. And then just to show you what the guest or what my client will receive, let me open up a new incognito window here. And I'm going to paste that link in the window in the URL. This is exactly what they will see on their end. When they click on the link, they're going to have access to these files and they can open them up. They can click on my bio. They can download it. They can print it out if they want. Of course, they can't edit it. They can download my pictures. Here are all the resources that I need. And remember, I've just got the one link, right? This is just the one link available here. I just need to remember or copy this link and use it multiple times, pretty much as how long I would like to, right? For the next coming years, if I want to. Now, the great thing is that whatever I do within this folder, it's going to automatically, you know, update. And anyone who has access to this is going to have the latest information. So for example, maybe I no longer, want this file, for example, available. I'm just going to hit delete on that. I'm going to put that in the trash can. And maybe in the future, I'm going to update my headshot, right? So I don't have to go out and email a variety of people and say, oh, by the way, could you please now use my updated headshot? Or can you put this in the program? If they have this link that I've given to them in advance, they're always going to have that updated information available to them. Now, you might be saying to yourself, Scott, I don't want to share that big, long, nasty link. That looks kind of intimidating. It looks very ugly. And yes, it is very, very long. Well, no, I don't recommend that you share the link in its natural state either. I'm going to copy that link one more time. So when I'm dealing with a client, I might share it in the following way. Here I am. I'm sending an email. Please use the link below to access my speaker resources. And I'm just going to call this Scott Friesen folder, something like that. All you need to do within Gmail or almost any other online editor is just highlight the text. I'm going to come down here to the bottom and select Insert Link. And it's here that I'm going to paste in that Google Drive link, right? This is the folder that I'm going to send them to. I'm going to hit OK. And now I've got a nice clean looking link, right? It looks straightforward. It tells them exactly what it is. And when they click on this link, they can get all of my resources. So, do you have a need for such an open shared folder? Remember, I only recommend this for documents or for files that you really don't mind the rest of the world gaining access to. Maybe there's a particular questionnaire that you send out to clients. Maybe there's some other documents or data that you like to share, and it's all right if other people have access to it, but they don't really need access to it until they become a client or at some step in the relationship. This is a great use for this type of shared folder within Google Drive. Well, I'd love to hear from you next. What other tips would you like to learn how to do right here within Google Drive? Be sure to tell me down below in the comments. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel. Give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to leave me a comment down below. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.